call the organizational meeting, the Jackson City School Board of Education order. Roll call, please.
McDonald.
Present.
Moore.
Here.
Harless.
Here.
Morris.
Here.
Smith.
Here.
All are present.
All right, need to move on to the election of the president. I have a motion.
I'll nominate Pat McDonald.
I'll second.
We just need a motion to close.
I need a motion, I'll make a motion to close the nominations.
Okay, I'll second that. That's what I meant anyway.
Harless.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
Smith.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
McDonald.
I'm staying. I need a motion for the election of vice president.
I'll nominate Brian Moore. And I'll make a motion to close the nominations.
Second.
Harless.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
Moore.
I'm staying.
Smith.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. Now we'll move on to setting meeting date for the year. Need a motion to establish the time and place regular board meeting to be the second Tuesday of each month at 7 p.m. in Jackson High School Room 110. With the exceptions listed below, the March 16th meeting, March meeting will be on March 16th, and the June meeting will be on June 29th. Are there any other issues with the dates?
Why is the March meeting different?
I had to change that one because of the process of something that's taking place in the meeting tonight. We have to have so many days in between meetings, and in order to make it come out right, I had to move that meeting.
Okay, thank you.
And have a motion on that?
I'll make a motion.
In a second.
Second.
Smith.
Yes.
Harless.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. Need a board service fund. I need a motion to establish the 2021 board service fund at $3,000.
So moved.
Second.
Morris.
Yes.
Smith.
Yes.
Harless.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. Standing authorizations, Mr. Howard.
I realize that pulling this down is not necessarily the proper way to wear my mask, but in order to be able to see so my glasses don't fog up, I'm going to pull this down below my nose. So otherwise, I'm not going to be able to see anything. It's recommended that the board approve the following standing authorizations. Item number one, authorization for the treasurer to secure advances on local taxes. Item number two, authorize the treasurer to procure operating banking services and invest funds. Item three, authorize the treasurer to pay the bills. Item four, authorize the treasurer and the president to borrow funds if necessary. Item five, authorize the superintendent to serve as the purchasing agent for the district. Item six, authorize the superintendent to employ personnel as needed for emergency situations. Item seven, authorize the superintendent on behalf of the board to accept resignations to later be approved by the board. Item eight, recommendation for the board to authorize the superintendent to approve unpaid employee leaves. Item nine, recommendation to authorize the superintendent to appoint a designee for appeals for student suspensions. Item 10, authorize the superintendent to approve employee requests for out-of-state trips for professional purposes. Item 11, authorize the superintendent to enter into a contract or agreement that has a value or cost of less than $50,000 when necessary, which would later be brought back to the board for ratification. Item 12, authorize the use of Robert's Rule of Orders. Item 13, authorize the superintendent to dispose of obsolete materials and equipment within the district. Item 14, authorize the superintendent during periods when the board's not in session to make offers of employment to candidates for teaching and non-teaching positions, again, to later be ratified by the board. Item 15, authorize the superintendent and the treasurer as board member designees to attend certified public records training. Item 16, authorize the superintendent to ban individuals from coming onto school property for various reasons. And item 17 is to authorize the superintendent to act as treasurer in the absence of the treasurer. And that concludes the standing authorizations.
I have a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
I'll second.
Smith?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. Now, I need a motion to approve the following appointments to the legislative liaison and board committees by the president. Legislative liaison, Pat McDonald. Personnel committee, Dr. Brian Morris. Program committee, Dr. Brian Morris. Athletic council representative, Brian Moore. Alternate, Kim Harless. Financial audit committee, Pat McDonald and Kim Harless. And student achievement liaison, Alice Smith. Can I have a motion to approve that in a second?
So moved.
Second.
Smith?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Motion.
And I need a motion to adjourn the organizational meeting.
I'll make a motion.
Second.
Harless?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
The organizational meeting is adjourned.
All right. I'd like to call the regular meeting of the Jackson City School Board of Education to order. And roll call, please.
McDonald?
Present.
Moore?
Here.
Harless?
Here.
Morris?
Here.
Smith?
Here.
All are present.
Now, could we all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Which flag?
Which flag?
I hear a pledge.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic. Which stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Move on to the approval of the agenda. Could I have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Smith?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. Now I need a motion to approve the minutes.
So moved.
And could I get a second?
I'll second it.
Morris and Smith.
Morris?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Moore?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. Need to go into executive session for a little while to discuss employment or negotiations or issues with public employees. So I have a motion to move into executive session.
So moved.
Second. Moore?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Morris?
Yep.
Smith?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. And we'll try to make this as quick as we can and get back as quick as we can.
Where are we going?
need to discuss, so we'll get back started. Need a motion to come out of executive session.
So moved.
Second.
We'll move on to School Board Recognition Month.
Yes, as most of you know, this is National School Board Recognition Month.
Oh, we don't get frames and everything this time. I've only got 15 of those. We don't get him.
Probably.
He doesn't love us. See, I'm blasting everything. Yes, it is. Thank you, sir.
Did you think she was going to number up?
I don't know if it's on the certificate, but I do. This is your 16th. Again, thank you guys for your service. Some years are tougher than others. I know this last year has been tough on a lot of people, a lot of school people, and even tough on board members. We've had to make a lot of tough decisions here in the last year or so. So again, thank you for your service.
All right, next part is public participation. We have nobody signed in on that, so we'll move on. No old business, and we'll move on with the consent agenda now. Mr. Howard, you want to?
Yeah, it's recommended that the board approve the consent agenda as follows. Item A is approving resignations, and there are several individuals there. Item B is a recommendation to approve an individual six-month classified contract for Leighton Maynard as a cleaning person. Item C, recommendation to employ individuals as certified substitute teachers. A couple of those are retroed back from a while back where I had to use them since the last board meeting. Item D is a recommendation to employ the following individuals as classified subs. There are three of those individuals there for the positions noted. Item E is a recommendation to approve latchkey personnel. Three different people there for the positions as noted. Item F is a recommendation to approve a lease agreement with Rye Grand College for our chemistry lab. We've done that in the past. Item G is a recommendation to update policies. And that, I believe that concludes the consent agenda.
Any items need removed for separate consideration from any board members? If not, need a motion and a second to approve.
So moved.
Smith.
Yes.
Harless.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. New business, ratification negotiated agreement with JCEA. I need a motion and a second to approve that agreement.
Second.
Harless.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
Smith.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. Now I need a motion and a second. I recommend OPSI 046 and 047. Also, be given a one-time 2% bonus and a 2% increase on their base salary.
So moved.
Morris.
Yes.
Harless. Moore?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. Also recommend that administration and exempt employees be given a 2% increase on their base salary and a one-time 2% bonus. And I need a motion and a second.
So moved.
You didn't want that to be Mr. McDonald? person. They both said it at the same time, so I don't know.
Just pick one.
Okay.
Doesn't matter.
Morris?
Yes.
Harless? Moore?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes. Public notice of retire, rehire, and I'll let you talk about that, Mr. Howard.
Yeah, and real quickly, before we get to that, I just want to say that we've just wrapped up, obviously, contract negotiations with our JCEA union. Myself and Mr. McDonald were representing the board on that. I want to thank the committee from JCEA. It was tough trying to find time to meet because of COVID and things. At one point, we had a meeting set, and I ended up getting COVID and couldn't make it. Mr. McDonald had a surgery at one point in time, so it was really tough to be able to get together and meet. But once we did, here we are in January. We're finally getting a contract. So in a nutshell, the contract, there are very little language changes in the contract. It's a 2% raise on the base salary, as well as a one-time 2% bonus is really the gist of the financial package of the contract. So item B is a recommendation to approve a public notice and public meeting for a discussion on the retire rehire of Scott Lowe. And again, you're not voting whether to retire or let him retire or rehire tonight. All you're doing is approving to have a discussion at a later time.
Need a motion and a second on the notice.
So moved.
Second.
Moore?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Harless?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
McDonald?
Yes.
Okay, quick question.
Yep.
Why do we have to have a discussion on that?
It's the law that whenever someone rehires into the same position, you have to have a public hearing. And that's why you had asked me earlier about that March 16th date.
Uh-huh.
It's really complicated as to how many days there can be between board meetings and between this hearing. And I had to adjust the March meeting to be able to fit in that window. So
Okay. There
has to be a hearing. You don't have to take the advice, but what it does is it allows the public the opportunity to be able to come in and say, I don't think you ought to do this, or I think it's a great idea, or nothing. Generally, when we've done it, there have been no one come to speak except when I did it, and there were a few people, but generally you end up no one comes to speak at it, but it does give the public the opportunity to do that.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. The next item, C, approval of the settlement agreement with the JCEA regarding the spring supplemental grievance as presented to the board by the superintendent. You want to?
I can real quickly
just talk about
go
that.
Over that. If you remember, it's been a long time ago because it was last spring sports. We got shut down by the governor in March, so we really didn't get to have, the kids didn't get to have a season. The board decided to pay our coaches 50% of their supplemental salary and take the other 50% that they would have been paid if it were completed in full and put that into their activity fund. The union filed a grievance on that, seeking their full 100% of the pay. I came back later at a meeting after that, a couple months after that, and made a recommendation to pay them at 100%, take the 50% out of the activity account funds. The board voted that down, and since then we have met and come to a decision, and this is a 70-30. The coaches will be paid 70%. 30% of their original contract amount would go into their activity fund for them to be able to use for their sport or their kids.
Thank you, Mr. Howard. Next item is item D, employment of supplemental
contracts.
I'm sorry.
Now, what all are we voting on?
We're voting on whether to accept to pay the coaches 70% and let 30% go into the activity fund.
So a motion and a second on that.
I'll second it.
Harless? Morris?
Yes.
Moore?
No.
Smith?
No.
McDonald?
Yes. Now we can move on to employment of supplemental contracts.
Okay, item D, there is a whole list of, I'm not going to dare try to read all those, of supplemental contracts that I'm requesting that the board approve. Some of those are spring sports coaches, some are winter. Now that we have ratified the contract, there is language in the contract that is now in there that wasn't in there last year for prorating the pay going forward. And up until then, that's why we've been approving our coaches as volunteers until the season was completed or nearly completed, so that we didn't run into another situation like that. But now we have language in the new contract that does allow for prorating the pay if the season is cut short. So we no longer have to do those volunteers. We can go ahead and hire the coaches, and if the season's not completed, there's a formula we will put in place to determine how much they should be paid. So there's a whole list of coaches and supplementals there that I would like for the board to approve.
Okay, I need a motion on.
So moved.
And a second.
Second.
Smith.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Harless. Yes. Morris.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. We'll move on. Item E, Northview, Westview paving project.
Yeah, as you know, the last 3 years, we've done a paving project here at the high school. We've done a paving project at the middle school. And then the last one that we did was out at Southview. We have these other two buildings that are left, and this is the contract for that work. And it will go to Almaz Construction. And I do want to also say that none of those projects, we have not taken money out of the general fund for those projects. If you remember, a few years ago, we had a kind of a dormant fund that was like $640,000 had been sitting there for years and years, and we sought permission from the county to take that money and be able to. Their only requirement was it had to be used as for a capital project or something. So we took that money. It had to, by law, go into the general fund, and then it was immediately transferred out of the general fund into our PI fund. So those paving projects have come from that, as well as our normal every year, the amount of money that we get for permanent improvement.
Sure.
There actually, there used to be a local company here called NUCO, and they had their own plant. So they've done work for us before. In fact, they did one of the two. Which job they do? They did the job here at Jackson High School a few years ago. So. Yeah.
All right, I need a motion and a second on the paving.
Second.
Smith.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Harless.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. Now we'll move on to the financial report. Ms. Strawser.
Yes, just item A is the Treasury's report for the period ending 12/31/2020.
Need a motion and a second.
So moved.
Second.
Smith.
Yes.
Moore.
Yes.
Harless.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
McDonald.
Yes. And item 10, youth sports.
Yeah, I just wanted to let the board know that with our youth sports, that I have informed our principals and athletic directors that anything below seventh grade, we're not going to allow practice in our facilities. You know, we've worked really, really hard to try to keep the schools open. And even in the elementaries, we have self-contained settings, and I think that's kind of defeating the purpose of the self-contained settings when we bring these little kids together and let them play basketball or wrestle and those kind of things and take them to other places. Additionally, for our high school and junior high athletes, the Ohio High School Athletic Association has a, for lack of a better term, policy that if a student athlete has contracted COVID, before they come back to participation, they have to have their heart checked. I don't know who's going to monitor that with these little kids, and I want to go on record as, you know, I can't control if a dad decides to call five or six other dads and decide to have a bunch of kids come down to the YMCA and have a practice. That's beyond my control. But it's not endorsed by the school district. And so if there's an event such as, you know, some kid gets to play and wasn't checked out, I don't want the school district to be held responsible for that. So I understand that it's important to kids, but you know, we've had kids missing proms and graduations and everything else. And these are, I think we can live without second, third, and fourth graders playing basketball and wrestling and doing some of these things. So that's, I just wanted to bring that to the board's attention that I have passed that on to our people. The next thing, just real quickly on COVID-19 updates, I have started a survey with our staff. We're partnering with the Jackson County Health Department for the vaccination for our employees of the district. And I think right now we probably had about 250 or thereabouts of our employees that had actually signed up. And we actually requested that they answer yes or no. And it appeared at the time, the last I saw it, about 25% of the people were saying no, 75% were going to receive the vaccination. I don't know how that, if that's more or less than what you thought. We're not sure when that's going to happen. I've talked to Kevin Aston at the health department. You know, the problem is being able to get them. I mean, it's he can use them as fast as he gets them. So we're in that tier 1B, I think it's called, and it's a huge tier. And I think it starts with like 80-year-old people, and then they decrease it by five years until they get down to 65. We are in that tier. So as soon as he gets enough vaccines for all the schools, then we will go ahead and roll it out to the school. It's probably going to be into February. And originally we thought maybe it might be quicker than that, but now it's looking like that based on the supply, it's going to be sometime, we're hoping, early February. But he's assured me that as soon as he gets enough of it, that we would go ahead and do that. I'm sure he's going to want to try to do all the schools at the same time so that it's not, he's not having to pick which school gets to go first or anything like that. But we will probably utilize our school nurses. We've got, you know, two nurses here. We'll probably utilize those and pick some dates. And as soon as we know, we will let our staff and let you know what dates we're actually going to take place. They work for us as coaches, but not teachers or whatever. Yes, yes. And I've had several people that, you know, if they're a substitute teacher, they work in the district, they're eligible. We've had some student teachers, you know, but because they're here with our kids all the time, those people are eligible. Any person that works in any capacity with any of our kids would qualify for that.
All right, move on to closing items. Are there any closing items, board members? Yes, Ms. Smith.
Should Dr. Morris begin working on Hall of Honor? And how about alumni? Are we going to have alumni? And
sure.
What are you thinking on graduation?
Well, we have.
I know it's early, but you got to think ahead.
With regard to the Hall of Honor, Ms. Strausser worked real hard at getting the pictures. I've got the pictures in my office for the wall. I mean, they look really nice. I think I showed them to one or two of you guys that were in there. They look really nice. But our problem right now is finding a time to be able to appropriately honor those people, because you're only allowed to have so many people at a ball game and stuff. So I'm thinking that maybe, and this is just me, if somebody wants to do something different, I'm fine with it. Maybe we end up inducting two classes at the same time. Hopefully this COVID thing is going to, you know, die down some, and so we can induct those three individuals, Ms. Pete Wilson, Mr. Barry, and
Jim Reynolds.
Those three have already been inducted. I've got their photos. So we could put those three with the next group of people and have a bigger one. So does that sound
good idea?
Sounds good.
Yeah.
All right, that's what we'll work towards. And, you know, anytime you want to start the process for the next group, feel free. Okay. And then what was your other question about
alumni graduation? What are you thinking?
I really don't have anything to do with the alumni. I mean, they'll make that decision whether they want to have that or not. And as far as whether we will have a graduation, I would like to think that, you know, there'll be some sort of a graduation. Now, I don't know that it'll be like it used to be with, you know, 5,000 people up there in the stadium, but I think that the way things are going now, that, you know, each kid will get X number of tickets at the very least. So unless this thing takes a turn for the worst, which we should be with the vaccine and stuff, headed for the better right now. So I think we'll have a graduation, and I think it'll be, you know, weather pending, obviously outside, or if not, we should be able to have one in here, but we might have to limit the number of people.
Thank you.
Anything else from anyone? If not, I need a motion to adjourn. So moved. Meeting adjourned.